But yeah, sorry. Just throwing my thoughts at you here, folks. I know, weird. You guys are nice. Some crowds don't take it as well. I got called a douchebag at a show recently. That's a fun word, huh? Douchebag? Yeah, because the insult is more popular than the actual product. I don't know anyone who's ever used a douche, never seen one. What is it, like a Ziploc? I have no idea, right? I feel bad for the guy who invented the thing. Some guy in the 1800s, I invented this thing for women's hygiene. We're all like, nice job, man. We're just going to use that to describe dudes and fedoras. I did some research on it. The douchebag actually bad for women. It's not good for you. So apparently the guy who invented it, kind of a douche. Well, that's the thing. I'm getting older, you know. I got to get it together, you know. Getting older. Getting older's tough. Everything kind of starts falling apart when you get older, you know. About a year ago, I got paranoid about losing my hair, started taking Propecia, could not get an erection. You remember, sir. Yeah, right. This girl I was dating at the time was like, hey, you gotta get off those pills. I'd rather have an erection than hair. Which is nice to hear, but that only makes sense when you're dating somebody. It doesn't work in the beginning. Like, if I was a bald guy that hit on her at a bar, like, hey, can I buy you a drink? She's like, I'm good. I'm like, ah, I have a boner. Hair loss is scary, man. I don't know if women realize how much guys think about that, you know? I was telling my friend, I'm like, I'm worried my hair is gonna thin. My friend goes, I know what you're going through, buddy. I'm going gray. I was like, well, changing color is a lot different than losing something. That'd be like if I said, yeah, I went to the beach the other day, shark attack. I lost my leg. My friend's like, I feel you, man. Tan line. Yeah. Being an adult, it's tough. You can tell being an adult is hard just by the abbreviations we use, you know? When you're a teenager, it's like LOL, OMG, BRB. When you're adult, you're like, shit, I got a DUI. I gotta go down the DMV, the IRS is up my ass, I got a UTI, my IBS is kicking in, I might have an STD, you know. Some kid's like, TMI, you're like, F you. Yeah, everything kind of changes when you get older, you know? My brother had a kid, that's crazy. Everybody wants to play with the baby, touch the baby, hug the baby. I find babies fascinating, because babies are the only thing that comes out of another person that strangers want to hold. You ever think about that? Anything else comes out of a human being, you're like, wow, this dinner party is over. But a baby, we're all about it. It's weird, we live in such a germophobic culture, you sneeze on a guy, he wants to kill you, but hey, a vagina monster, goochie goochie goo. Very interesting. Something to think about, you know? There's some perks to getting older, though. I think older women are sexy, yeah. Anybody here been through menopause? Might be a younger crowd. I'm very ignorant when it comes to this stuff. You ladies really keep a lid on this shit, you know? Like my aunt's going through menopause right now. She's bummed out, she's depressed. I thought that would be a good time. Menstruation's over. Years of discomfort over. Come on, you graduated, sister. It's time to move that tampon string to the side. Right? Why isn't that a party? Where's that Facebook invite, huh? Hey, Aunt Marie, stop bleeding every month. All right! Everybody in the pool. Yeah, sorry if this is too dark, and I'm just being myself here, folks. People tell you to be yourself your whole life. That is the worst advice on the planet. Yourself sucks. Every time I've been myself, I've been fired, kicked in the balls, dumped, whatever. Don't ever be yourself. Yourself is gross and naughty. Self is the worst version of you. That's why whenever you walk into an elevator alone, there's no one else in there, you're like, ooh, I'm here by myself. I can be weird. There's no one else in here. Yeah, all right. Then some other guy walks in, you're like, crap, I got a boner, I've been queefing. Ah, damn it. Yeah, you gotta adapt. You gotta go back to society, you know? And people tend to be yourself at the worst times, too. Hey, you got a hot date tonight, Mark? Just be yourself. All right. You're sitting at dinner, some girl's like, so, Mark, what are you thinking about? I'm like, well, just thinking, you know? You rarely see any female pedophiles, which is probably for the best, because they can make their own kids. Being me. The worst times. Hey, you got a job interview? Just be yourself. All right. You're in some office. Some guy's going, so, Mark, what What's your worst quality? Well, you know, I always start masturbating when I'm already late for something. Huh. Wow, all right. Jesus Christ. Didn't see that one coming at all. Quite a curveball there. Whew. Well, I gotta ask now, what's your best quality? Pretty fast masturbator. I don't think we're gonna need you here at the Build-A-Bear. Thank you. All right, yeah. I like phony. Phony's underrated. Phony gets a bad rap, you know? Why is that like an insult? That guy's a real phony. I love phony. Phony makes the world go round. Waiters, they don't care about you. They're being phony, and it's nice. The phonier they are, the more you tip. Nice hotel, come on in, sir. We're so glad you came. That guy didn't give a rat's ass about you. He's being phony. We pay top dollar for phony. Right? I don't want a stripper who's authentic. Yeah. I'm getting a lap dance. I'm like, yeah, you like that? She's like, well, I'm just trying to get my kids back. Go back, come back, come on in. Come back, come back. Phony, phony.